In this brief video, we're going to learn how to add additional fields to a table in an Acces database, and then we're going to learn how to create queries, how to create forms, and how to create a report based on a table in our database. Stay tuned. We're going to also learn later how to create multiple tables in a database and how to link those tables together and utilize additional functions in Microsoft Acces 2016. So we have our table that we designed earlier, and now we want to add, let's say, to make a small change. As I had mentioned earlier, you don't want to make too many changes after data has been entered in the table, but this is just for demonstration purposes. So to enter a new field, we could do it a couple of ways here. We could either click here on click to add, and then choose a type of field that we want to add, or we can go here under view and then choose the design view. So design view, it's this next one. Now we scroll all the way to the bottom here, and then let's say we want to state whether this is a new customer or not. So it's going to be a yes or no field. So we say new customer, and then we want to change this on the drop down here to be yes or no. What the system is going to do there is going to allow us to put a check mark, basically have a checkbox. Once we have tweaked that, you can add additional fields in there. By the way, you have here under description in the design view, you have an area where you can actually put notes, design notes for you as a designer of this database. You could say, additionally, you can go up further for any of those fields and such. As we covered very briefly in the last session, each table needs to have a primary key. And the primary key can be a number field, it can be anything, but it has to be something. Typically, it's a number and an auto number, something that increases, or some kind of code. And it is what differentiates one record from another. So if you have two people with the same name and the same address, then in order to differentiate them, the best way would be to simply assign them a new ID or to have different IDs. So the primary key typically in the database design here, since we are in this view, it's represented with this little golden key. If you wanted to change it to a different field and make that the primary key, you can. However, it has to be the right kind of field. If you changed it to this one, then that means that there can be no two people with the same name on that table. So you want to make sure that you set the primary key on the correct field. And that's why typically it's an ID or something, a number that is generated by either the system or you assign it manually, but that number has to be unique. So I'm going to make this back as the primary key. And now let's suppose that we are done with the design here. We can click on close, save the design changes. And now let's learn how to create a form. Forms typically are utilized for entering data. You could enter the data in here, but if you have a lot of fields here or those columns and you have a lot of data, first it would be very dangerous to delete records that you're not supposed to delete, but secondly, it's not the most user-friendly interface to enter new data. So therefore, what we can do here is we can go under the Create tab, and you want to create what's called a form. The forms, you can create them from scratch, you can design them from here, or you can use the form wizard. And I'd recommend that you utilize the form wizard. It's much simpler, much easier to do this. Go under form wizard here. And basically the way it works is that you tell the system which table you want to use. In our case, we have only one table here. So then you pick here what fields you want to include in that form. By the way, you can design multiple forms based on the same table. You're basically saying, I want to feed data only for first name, last name, and address, and you give access to a specific individual to just utilize that form, while other individuals may have access to update more areas of your database. So here, we are just picking the fields that we want. You can pick them one at a time, or you can simply add all the fields in one shot here by clicking on this double arrow icon and then click on next. Then you can choose how you want your form to be displayed and organized, and you can play with this on your own, but typically columnar, it's basically going to go up and down in a sequence basically. Then click on next, and then you give it a name. And then it says open the form to view or enter the information, or open to modify the design even further. So in our case here, we are simply going to click on finish. Notice it has designed our form for us to enter the data. So notice it has this, it's displaying the first record that we had entered already in our table. Now, you might say, well, about this field file 1, file 2, file 3, this is because we chose one of the fields to have attachments, and these are just the attachment fields here. Also, keep in mind that you can design this form, and we'll learn about changing the design of forms in later as well, but for now we are just learning about the basic concept of how forms work in a database and how they relate to tables. So stay tuned for the other functionality there. So in our case here, the form here serves to display information that is already stored in the tables, or it also serves for us to enter new records and create, add new customers here. So if I click here, add a new blank record, we leave the customer ID alone here, and then we just fill in the information. Now notice that this, it's not quite lined up properly and all that type of thing. I'll show that in a moment, how to readjust the size of those. And then you basically just fill in the information. If we go to the next record, it's basically, it's stored what we just entered, and then you can just create a new one and keep on doing this. So typically, it's the forms that your assistant is going to use to enter data and look up information. Typically, your users do not really need to touch the tables and entering data and such, because the system will enter the data using the forms. So hopefully you get the idea there. Now, if I'm to go here to my table, by the way, you need to close any of those other things that you might have opened here in the main area. And we open the table here. Notice that I have now Jim Smith, my new customer that I entered manually, or that I entered through the form. So again, the forms are very similar to the input function in the computer. And you utilize them to view what's stored in the table and to store new data in the table. Now, to modify this form, just very briefly here, you can click here under View and then choose Layout View, and you can kind of just simply resize this stuff if you need it to. So this is one way to resize it or to adjust the design of it. It's somewhat simpler. The other method to modify the view of this form is by clicking here on View, just like we use the design view to modify the design of the table, we can use the design view to modify the design of our form here. So if we click on design view, now it becomes a little bit more complicated and such. That's why I said that the other method was slightly simpler. Here is where you can change in a more precise way the design of this. So here you could actually go and say, instead of first name without the space there, you could simply go ahead and change it, put the space in there. You can format that to be in bold, and you could change the design of those fields and such. Additionally, from this view, and it's not time for us to learn about it, but if you needed to, it's these second fields here, the ones in white, that are basically connecting. So you don't want to change this wording here to put it in space. That's the code that it links to the table, because basically it's saying it's going to pull from that first name field on the actual table. So you don't want to change these. If you right click in here, and unfortunately I cannot display it here for you to view it, but if you go to properties in the bottom, because of my recording, the way I have the recording of the screen, And notice that the control source, it says here, so it's pulling the data from the customer information table, and it's pulling the from the field first name. So this is more complicated, but just for your information, you don't want to change this second area here. Then once you're all set here, we can close this, save the changes to it. And then if we go back to our form, notice first name here, it's in bold and such. So hopefully this makes sense on how the forms relate to the tables in an Acces database. Now let's create a quick query here and see how queries work in a very basic way. So if we go here to our table and we click on create, and now we go here under the query wizard, and the way queries work is basically you can connect to a table and you are saying list all the customers from that table, or list only the customers from a specific zip code or a specific city or a specific state. So you're putting criteria within that query or that question. So basically you're simply asking a question, give me limited information based on this specific criteria. So here, let's say we want the first name, last name, and then the street address and the city and a zip code. Then we click on next, and then it says customer information query, click on finish, and notice we got only what we requested. So we have first name, it's listing all the customers by first name, by last name, street address, city, and zip. The concept to keep in mind here is that there is no data stored within this query itself. The data is still stored in the table. The query just stores the parameters of what our criteria is. So to run this query, all you have to do is you double click here on the query and it pulls the data right away. If we were to go and change specific data here for a specific customer, let's say we had a fourth customer here. And I'm entering this using the form. Now if I go and run this query, notice I have customer 4 listed here. So the idea is that you can create as many queries as you want, whatever options that you want. You know, the manager might say, I need a query. I need to know how many sales you did today. So you could say, okay, give me all the customers, give me all the items that were sold, but based on a specific day of the week or such. So that's very briefly the queries. If you needed to change and we'll learn how to modify the queries, so just check the next tutorial on customizing and working with queries in a database. Now next, in this session, we are going to learn how to create a report. Reports in a database are a key element as well. It's very similar to outputting information. You want to print it out, particularly it's to organize the data in a certain way. It's very similar to queries, but the queries are displaying the data in a very Excel-like worksheet here. The reports are designed to look nicer so that you can print them out and hand them over to somebody. So to create a report, again, you'd go under the Create option here, or the Create tab, and then you want to go under Reports, and my suggestion would be that you utilize the Report Wizard. So here you're picking what table you want to pull the report from. Notice that you can pull a report from queries as well. So it's, the reports are built from tables or from queries. So whenever you build a report on the query, the report is actually going to that query and pulling the data. So for now, we're going to use it directly from the table. And then we say, I want the customer ID, let's say the first name, last name, and the street address, and whatever else that you want here, zip code and such. And then we click on next. Now at this stage, we have the option next, and then we can choose how to sort those customers, let's say by first name or by last name or by customer ID, and you can put different searching options here or sorting options. Click on next, click on finish, and now notice here we have the report called customer information. Notice it's slightly more visually pleasing here. And you can also adjust the design of this very similar to how we did earlier for other components here. So we can go and adjust the design by going to the layout view and then resize those fields accordingly. Now, typically the numbers here, this number sign, that means that it does not fit in that field. So you need to still resize this. Or the other method here to adjust the design of this is by going here under view and then go under design view. So again, the concept is whether you want to change the design of the tables, the forms, or the queries or reports, you have the different views that you can change the design of them. And particularly, you want to use the design view for designing any of those components of the database. Now, when we are done with this report, we close it. Since we tinkered with the design here, just click on save to save it. Close the other elements as well. And then go here under customer information. This is our report. And that's the data that it's pulling from the table here. So hopefully all this makes sense in how a database, our very basic database with one table, works, and how the various elements of the database, particularly those key four components, there are other components that you add as well, such as macros and things of that nature, but these are the main key components of a database that you utilize typically.